I'm Gina Emmanuel. This is my husband, Jared Whitson. And you can go ahead and start the first one. This is our house, and I'm an architect, and Jared is a cabinet maker. And we decided we're moving to this house a few years ago. It was a really small house that we were not going to buy any more furniture. Everything that we put in there, we were going to design, and Jared was going to build it. And so that's kind of what you're going to see in the next round of life. Some of you might, probably a lot of you know who Charles and Rankins are. And for those of you that don't, they're really, really great designers, architects, furniture makers. They've done some really iconic furniture. And so we are like to pretend that we're like them. And one day we're going to be really famous like that, and people are going to buy our furniture and spend thousands of dollars on it. So we tried to pose ourselves just like them in the picture.
If you look at the tile work here, June and I tiled this a couple years ago. And that Mexican tile kind of served as an inspiration for the next piece that you're going to see. You look at this geometrical pattern here, and the kind of the prototype of the door above it, you can see that we were kind of just inspired by this for this piece, which...
Well, like I said, we had no... It's a small house. There's no storage anywhere. So pretty much a lot of what you're going to see are pieces of storage. But this is our buffet, and we couldn't really use half of our plates and cups, so we decided to make this really big piece. And Jared had access to some cherry wood that's kind of covered the whole thing. Somebody had it in his basement for about 30 years, and so that's what we've used for cabinets.
You can see that the doors, you saw that one circular pattern. These were made with kind of a plywood we made ourselves out of cherry, walnut, and maple. And then we cut these different depth holes so that you can see each individual piece of the door.
This is the rest of our dining room. I'm going to talk mostly about this bench that Jared never wanted. I had to pretty much fight him to do a bench. He said, I don't want a bench. They're not comfortable. Nobody ever wants to sit on them. But I finally convinced him to do it. And so this is what we got. We really needed a seating for our house because we had a big family.
This is actually the first piece of all these that we made. It's just a shaker table that actually, I made it not intending to use it for our house. We both have really large families. It's come in real handy. It's a real large table. It's got a painted poplar base. It's a milled paint. It's all water-based, something that we really care about. This is the actual bench, and the kind of interesting thing about this is that it's actually never left Nashville since it were first grown as a tree. It was cut down, and I got a piece of this tree and made the bench, and it sits in our house. I guess we'll leave it there. This is my brother and I in our shop, my brother Ezra. We have a cabinetry business here, and he actually helped us out with pretty much everything you see there, building and finishing all this stuff.
And, probably a lot of this wouldn't get built if he wasn't. This is our shop helper, who looks a lot cuter in the picture than he is in real life. But he goes to the shop with Jared every day, because if he was at our house, this furniture would probably not be there anymore. So he helps us with the shop chewing up all the trees.
This is a side table. It's a third of a few pieces that you'll see. It's made of walnut. It's kind of a traditional construction, but a more contemporary piece. It's a dovetailed solid wood piece. The next pieces that you see are really the inspiration for it. This is the chested drawer, six drawer chested drawer.
This was supposed to be a Christmas present for me, but I got it in March.
Yeah. You'll notice that a number of these were supposed to be presents or work presents. I guess that's kind of what the workers do for presents. If you notice, let me go to the next. The mirror, actually, the first of the pieces, this was actually also a present. And, possibly the only time that I surprised Gina was presenting this one for her birthday. It worked out pretty well.
We found out I was pregnant. We wanted to design all of our baby furniture, and so this is not ours. This is basically what we didn't want, but this is what you can get everywhere. And so we tried to make sure we didn't want to have to go buy one of these and put them in our house. So you'll start seeing in the next slides what we ended up.
This is the crib that we designed, and that's our son Joseph. We built this out of plywood and water-based finishes. We wanted something.
And we designed this in about 45 minutes because I was about 7 months pregnant and we didn't have anything to put all of our clothes. They were just mounted up on the floor. And it was a good thing that we designed it because Joseph was born a month early. So we basically had this put in the house a few days before I had him put all the clothes in. And then
It's actually sort of a prototype of something we've been trying to do, to create some furniture that is easier to produce than some of the other stuff. It's cut on a CNC router. It's a more modern kind of design. It's also all water-based and formaldehyde free products. You can see that moving on to the next one. These are some chairs that we made, actually, for Gina's birthday.
Different
birthday, yeah. You spread it out. These are cypress wood with a clear finish. It will last a long time, so you can party with your outdoors.
And we have a small office in our house, about 7 feet by 16 feet, so it's really small. And again, we had nowhere to put our books or all of our dog food and everything like that, so we kind of snuck these shelves in wherever we could. And there's another one behind it, but they're just cantilever shelves that we fit. I mean, they're about 6 inches deep, so they're not very deep. So you can only really put certain things on it, but it really helped us out.
And then finally, what we've got planned for next is some seating to replace those two chairs right there. That's something we really kind of like to get rid of. We're designing
it. We're going to try to design a couch.
A couch. It'll be the first for us. So
we'll see how it works.
That's the last one.